you're starting your professional career as
Yes, we are.
Well, bear in mind, a cuddly teddy bear can make all the difference for a child who's afraid of visiting the hospital.
Yeah, Monica White and Lindsay from Portneuf Medical Center join us now to tell about their teddy bear clinic. Monica, how long have you guys been doing this program?
33 years.
That is crazy.
Wow.
It is crazy. And one of my favorite things is when parents come through and they say, I did this when
I was 8 years old. Yeah. I was doing this with the teddy bear. Now they're kids.
I have not been doing it 33
years. No.
But of course, we would not have thought
But it's a great event. We expect about 2,000 people to converge on us tomorrow, mostly kids toting teddy bears.
Yeah. Okay, so they bring that teddy bear, and the purpose of that is to show them what you guys do in a hospital,
exactly.
But on the bear, right?
Yes. Lindsay will tell you a little bit about what the kids will experience.
Yes, the kids will be able to go through all the different stations. We have about 32 stations that they can go through within the first two levels of the hospital. And stations like their favorites are casting and X-rays. They can get a little cast, obviously. They can
on the teddy bear.
On the teddy bear, mind you. It gets them just comfortable with the atmosphere. It can increase awareness of what all happens and make them feel a little more comfortable coming to the hospital and. Mm-hmm. And it kind of gives them the opportunity to become the parent to the teddy bear.
Huh. Yes.
And put them in that role. They're going to want to take care of it and do everything they can to make it feel good.
Now, Monica, you've been doing this for a couple years.
A couple.
What is your experience when the kids come in? Do you find that some of the kids are, like you mentioned, the parent to the bear or the stuffed animal, and they get a little concerned when things start happening? But the physicians and the nurses and the doctors are all very careful about explaining what's going on, aren't they?
Absolutely. I've seen kids who actually come for surgery, say to have their tonsils out, that they'll bring their teddy bear that still has its cast
still has.
And its wristband.
Hasn't that bear healed by now?
It's like their Mickey Mouse ears, you know, it's
okay.
Kind of their souvenir for the
nice.
Hospital. And I think when they come tomorrow, it's very fun, it's very carnival-like, I think.
Uh-huh.
But when they come as the patient, they don't feel good, they're sick.
Right.
But we want them to know that we're going to help them get better, that we're not the bad guys. We are going to help you. What you have to go through might be bad,
right.
But we're here to help you. So
help
I
you
think
get better.
It really
help
puts
you,
their minds at
help
ease.
Help you bear well.
Bear well. Nice.
Boom, boom, boom.
Does it have to be a teddy bear? Does it matter what size the animal is?
We were just looking at pictures yesterday, and there was a boy who brought a trout, a stuffed trout, and I had missed that. We've had dinosaurs, we've had fish, it does not have to be a teddy bear.
Okay, and of any size?
Any size, any shape. You don't have to come just at 10 o'clock. It runs from 10 to 2. It takes about an hour, but you pick and choose what you want to do. So really, you have to be there by 1 o'clock to see everything.
Okay.
And Lindsay, this is a great opportunity, too, not just to get kids familiar with the hospital environment, but kind of teach them good health as well, isn't it?
Yeah, definitely. There's a lot of stations that will teach them to, like, sunscreen protection. Mm-hmm. They'll give them little sunglasses from the cancer center. There's also a lot of things that'll just help them be better as kids and
dental
be able
hygiene,
to enjoy.
Teaching them how to brush their teeth.
Mm.
And of course, one of the other highlights is the LifeLight helicopter.
Oh, yes.
Assuming they're not out on a call, the kids can actually sit in the helicopter.
Oh, cool.
Okay, we're sold. We will be there.
You
drive by it every day. They have to point out if the helicopter's there or not. We will be there.
All right, so what time does it start?
10 o'clock.
10 o'clock, and it runs until?
Until 2.
Until 2.
Yep.
So anytime. People can just pop in anytime between
exactly.
10 and 2.
Is there an entrance they're supposed to go to?
The south entrance, which is our main entrance, is where you actually start. You'll see the line of kids, but it really does move very smooth. You don't have to wait long. We have a lot of help. That's the other thing. I have 100 volunteers, and I've not had to send a call for help. They have called me.
Ah.
It's a great way for the community to help us. We have Eagle Scout projects. National Honor Society. We have nursing students that are visiting with the kids as real patients. So it's been a fabulous community extension.
That's great.
Fantastic.
And
Monica,
of course, we're raffling off or giving away. We're drawing these teddy bears.
Okay. Door prizes.
Fantastic.
Yeah.
Good deal. All right. It all happens tomorrow. Lindsay, Monica, thank you so much for coming
Thanks
in today.
For having
we
you.
Appreciate
thank
that.
You.
And coming up, a Utah soldier battling with Apple over a new phone. Oh, yeah. We talked about it earlier. We'll tell you what's coming up next.